Hello everyone, you're welcome to my channel Learn and Earn Academy. And today in this video, we are going to learn what is a bailout. Now you must have heard this term in news, bailout. Now what exactly is the meaning of this word and when is a bailout used? Now bailout is a general term for extending financial support to a company or a country facing a potential bankruptcy threat. Now, we can relate this to the economic slowdown. We can also relate it to the COVID-19 situation which is at present. What happens? Because of this difficult circumstances, the industries, the business, the economies are not able to function properly. And since they are not able to function properly, they do not generate revenue. And if you're not able to generate revenue, obviously your business will take a hit and it will run into loss. Eventually, you will have to close your business. Now imagine if in an economy, all the industries suddenly closed because of COVID-19, they are not able to function properly. There are so many restrictions. Now, will it not have an impact on economy? Yes, it will have an impact. The economy will slow down. The industries will declare themselves bankrupt. They cannot pay their employees. They will not generate any income. And that is where bailout comes into picture. Bailout is an opportunity. Bailout is a way in which the government tries to revive the economy, tries to revive the organization by giving a helping hand, by supporting. So bailout is basically an attempt to bring life to a dead organization, to bring, you know, prosperity, to bring functioning, to bring cash, to let the organization function somehow. You know, try the last mile approach. Anything that can be done to save the organization, the companies, the economy, that is called bailout. So I hope you got the concept absolutely clear. Now it can take the form of a loan, a cash, bond or stock purchases. Bailout can be in different forms. That depends upon the government, that depends upon the economy and what kind of bailout you want to give to your industry, to your people. For example, I'll give you a very good example. RBI has come out with a bailout to the people who are paying EMIs. RBI has already deferred or given the opportunity for a customer not to pay the EMIs for 3 months. It can be extended to 6 months only because he may not get proper income because of COVID-19, and that is a form of bailout. So it doesn't have to be necessarily in form of cash. It could be in any form. So basically it's a help out, right? It's a help which the RBI, which the government is giving to the people because they know that people are not able to generate income. They are not getting salary. So a bailout may or may not require reimbursement and is often accompanied by greater government oversight and regulations. The reason for a bailout is to support an industry that may be affecting millions of people internationally and could be on the verge of bankruptcy due to prolonged financial crisis. I'll give you an example of commercial banks. Now you must have seen that all the commercial banks, because of high NPAs, they have faced a lot of problems, because of which the government has given money in form of bailout packages so that they can sustain, so that they can run properly. That is another form of bailout. So reason is basically to bring the organization on its feet. Types of bailout: it could be in a form of direct loan, a third party guarantee, it could be direct subsidies given by the government, it could be stock purchases by the government, it could be restrictions of import and export, not allowing foreign players to participate so that the local industries get an opportunity. Restructuring of the organization or the loan through banks, temporary relaxations of examples such as GST payment, such as deferment of EMIs. Now, these are the ways in which the government gives bailout. What are the advantages? Yes, the bailout has certain advantages and disadvantages as well. The advantage is that the survival, it ensures continued survival of the entity. Yes, a complete collapse of the financial system can be avoided. Yes, if all the industries fail, it will be a failure for the entire country. So it's important for the government to think and give a bailout package to these industries. The government in these cases step in to avoid the insolvency of the institution. Insolvency is bankruptcy when they are not able to pay their debt. That situation government wants to avoid. So the government wants to just give them a helping hand so that they come out and they can, you know, do some business. Now, there are certain disadvantages as well. Anticipated bailouts encourage moral hazard by allowing not only promoters but also high stakeholders to take higher than recommended risk in financial transactions. For example, the relaxation which is given by RBI to all the customers to defer the payment by 3 months, many of the people who may be in a position to pay may not be willing to give that out. They may not be able to, even if they have the money, they are not paying the EMIs because they have got an opportunity. So in some way it's a big disadvantage as well. This happens because they start counting on a bailout when things go wrong. Similarly, the waivers, which normally the if there is a problem, they should definitely get. But most of the farmers, you know, wait for the bailout packages, especially during the time of election, when the politicians promise to waive all the farm debts. Yes, farmer suicide is a genuine problem and it should definitely be taken care of. But to waive off all the debt of a farmer because of a political gimmick is not doing the right thing, because it is going to affect the economy. Because at the end of the day, we as the Indian people, the common man, is paying for that, right? It's our hard-earned money. So that has to be also taken care of. Thank you.